Hello everyone, we have Dr. Charles Reigeluth with us, and he is a professor emeritus at Indiana University and the author of the book Vision and Action, Reinventing School Through Personalized Competency-Based Education. And he has researched personalized learning for more than 30 years, and so I'm very excited to have this conversation with him. Hello, Dr. Reigeluth, thank you for being here.
Hello, it's great to be here.
Okay, so to start off our conversation, why do you think personalized learning is critical in our current society?
That's a really important question. Our teacher-centered, one-size-fits-all system was really perfect for the industrial age because most of the work was manual labor, and we needed a system that could sort out the laborers and continue to educate the professionals and managers. But now in the information or digital age, knowledge work is becoming predominant. So many more people need to learn so much more. Our sorting focus system with student progress based on time rather than learning cannot achieve that. Second, there are many more careers now. Standardized education where all students are supposed to learn the same things is no longer appropriate. We need to cultivate individual talents and interests. This will better serve our students and our communities. Third, there is much greater need for lifelong learning today, given how rapidly job knowledge changes and how much more often people change careers during their lives. So we need skill and will for lifelong learning. Personalized learning develops both the joy of learning, the will part, and the skills to be successful at it. Our current time-based, sorting-focused, teacher-centered system was invented for the industrial age and no longer meets the needs of our society.
Well, thank you for your answer. Then what do you think are the essential components of personalized learning?
Well, to truly personalize learning, many aspects of our educational systems need to change. The most important is the change from time-based student progress to learning-based student progress, so students don't accumulate gaps in their learning that make it much harder for them to learn related material in the future. This means competency-based education, in which students move on to the next topic only when they have mastered the current topic. Second, for this to be possible, project-based learning is very helpful because different students will be working on different things at any given point in time, and because it can be a powerful motivator. Third, this requires a greater amount of self-directed learning because it enhances student motivation, makes personalized learning easier for teachers to manage, very important, and enhances lifelong skills. Fourth, it also benefits from collaborative or team-based learning because that also improves motivation for students and makes it easier for teachers to manage because students get much feedback from their peers. So personalized learning needs to be supported by competency-based education, project-based learning, self-directed learning, and collaborative learning.
Well, thank you. So now from the theoretical perspectives, what theories support personalized learning or its components?
Wow, there are many theories. Different theories support different aspects of personalized learning, given all these essential components. It's helpful to understand that there are two kinds of support: rationale, which we call descriptive theory, and guidance, which we call design theory. The latter is far more useful to teachers. One class of theories is motivational theories, which includes needs theory by McClellan and arcs theory by John Keller. Needs theory says that there are three fundamental human needs or motives: need for achievement, need for affiliation, and need for power. We can meet the need for achievement through competency-based education, the need for affiliation through collaborative learning, and the need for power through self-directed learning. Bloom's mastery learning provides rationale and evidence why competency-based education can be effective. Theories on self-regulated learning and self-determination theories allow us to design self-directed learning in an effective way. Another class of theories is cognitive learning theories, which include schema theory, information processing theory, social cognitive theory by Bandura, and others. Bandura's theory emphasizes the value of social modeling, among other things. And yet another class of theories is constructivist learning theories, which include cognitive constructivism, social constructivism, constructionism by Piaget and Papert, and various other theories. These theories support collaborative learning, project-based learning, and other inquiry-based approaches. Behaviorist theories can also be useful for many kinds of emotional learning, as well as memorizing information, which is sometimes useful, although currently typically overused in our schools. These theories include classical conditioning theory and reinforcement theory. And there are many other theories that support different aspects of personalized learning.
Well, thank you. So we will have a lot of teachers who will be reading this book and taking the personalized learning course. So what would you say the role of the teachers in personalized learning?
Yeah, this is very important. It's a very different role from in our current paradigm of education. In my Vision in Action book, I talk about the role of guide on the side rather than sage on the stage. And I talk about five sub-roles for the guide on the side. Mentor of students with multi-year mentoring, very, very important. Designer or curator of learning resources, including projects, tutorials, and more. Facilitator of learning, which itself has many sub-roles, helping the students while they are engaged in the learning process. Collaborator and consultor with other teachers to help them and to get their advice about how best to meet students' needs. And one of the most important is teacher as learner, learning with students, about students, for students, and from students.
That's excellent. So current requirements, from the law or from the school system, they have a lot of requirements and pressure. So what would you suggest an individual teacher do?
Yeah, there are many constraints on what they can do, but in spite of those constraints on their teaching, like grades, schedules, standardized tests, lack of resources, there's still much they can do in their classrooms. They can use collaborative projects, ones that are student designed or selected for them, to help them master the standards that they're responsible for. There are project banks where they can find projects that have already been developed by teachers. They can also use online tutorials like the Khan Academy to help their students master the competencies that they need in their projects. And they can offer their students the opportunity to revise their work in order to reach mastery. Most of all, giving personalized attention to individual students and building relationships are super important. They can have short one-on-one meetings or plan some activities where they can get to know individual students. But ultimately, they need to help their schools to transform to personalized learning, not just their individual classrooms. And most important here is helping other teachers and administrators to evolve their mindsets or mental models about what education should be like. This takes many conversations with those colleagues, which none of you really has much time for, but those conversations are very important. Sharing readings can also help. It's also helpful to know that there are over 1,000 schools nationwide that have transformed to some form of personalized learning with all its components. Arranging for a site visit with their colleagues can be very helpful. I really hope that your students will all take on this challenge to transform to personalized learning, because it is so important for our children and our communities.
Well, thank you so much for sharing your insights, Dr. Reigeluth.
I'm very happy. Thank you so much for inviting me. I appreciate it. Mm-hmm.